Roads have always been an important part of Georgia history. Native Americans used trails for war and trade. English colonists built roads to connect forts, and Civil War battles often took place where two roads met. But as Georgia outgrew its roads, both our state and the nation needed something more, and that something became the interstate highway system.
In 1911, a national automobile race sponsored by the Glidden Paint Company passed through Georgia, and people saw firsthand how bad the state's roads were.
We got to realize that Georgia, a lot of our main highways weren't paved well up into the 1930s. And after World War II, one of the things we saw was the Germans had the system of autobahns, four-lane divided roads, and we saw that this was a good way to get around.
In the late 1930s, President Franklin Roosevelt came up with the idea of an American interstate highway system, copying the success of the German autobahns.
The new national auto highways connect all points of economic, cultural, and scenic importance in Germany. Since there are never any crossroads, they are the safest highways in the world.
Construction of America's autobahns was finally started in the 1950s under the Truman administration.
Soon, traffic will flow smoothly in, around, and between every major city and town in America. There will be no traffic tie-ups where the interstate goes. Driving time will become minutes for local trips, and city-to-city travel will be shorter by hours.
Drivers loved the new interstates. They were faster, safer, and brand new. And traffic along the older, slower roads was reduced to a trickle, which meant that thousands of motels, gas stations, and restaurants went broke because travelers didn't stop there anymore. Ludowici, Georgia looks like a storybook town in South Georgia. Life is relaxed here, a place for neighbors and front porch conversations. Ludowici has been a crossroads for travelers since colonial times. Harry Chapman says this had always been a bustling town. The railroad in the 1840s and U.S. Highway 301 in the 1930s brought people and industry to Ludowici.
Ludowici was really on the boom, that's right. There was big sawmills, there was big cotton gins, there was stores all right down here. This became the center of town after it became Ludowici.
There were drug stores. There was a drug store there, a dress shop, a dime store, two grocery stores, and the Ludowici News.
After World War II, cars and gasoline were inexpensive, and Americans loved to travel in their cars. Since the 1930s, U.S. Highway 301 has been the main road for Northerners to go south to Florida. Back then, 6,000 cars and trucks drove through Ludowici every day. It was a good place to stop, have a bite to eat, pump some gas, or stay the night.
And this was rather a captive audience, you might say. Those people weren't going down 301 because they wanted to see 301. They were trying to get to Florida or back home from Florida. And they needed all sorts of services. They needed food, they needed gasoline, they needed a place to sleep. And so this economy, this tourist economy, grew up all along 301 to serve that captive traveling public.
Virgil Nail and her husband built the Rainbow Motel in 1954.
Well, they stopped in Ludowici because they were hard up for somewhere to stay, I suppose, spend the night. And then they, a lot of them that I remember, I came down once in a while and at night and talked with them. And a lot of them were from Pennsylvania. I remember more Pennsylvania and New York cars than any other state.
For 100 miles, you couldn't get a motel room after 6 o'clock.
People called Highway 301 the Green Tunnel because of the money they earned from it.
During the 301 traffic that we had, 7 days a week, there was no problem filling up all rooms before dark every day.
But the economic boom in Ludowici went bust when Interstate 95 came along in 1967 It was just 25 miles away, and travel through South Georgia went from this to this. How could 301 and little Ludowici compete against this giant strip of steel and concrete, the billions of dollars being spent by the federal government? You could drive faster on the interstate. There weren't any stoplights or stop signs, and Interstate 95 ran directly to where people wanted to go. That competition ruined Ludowici's economy.
It was like turning off a switch. When Interstate 95 was completed, or a significant portion of it up in South Carolina, so that the route was open, so you didn't have to go down 301 anymore, people chose to go down the brand new four-lane interstate freeway rather than go down this old two-lane highway. And as I say, this captive tourism market essentially disappeared overnight.
In its heyday, Ludowici boasted three first-class motels. Many more were nearby, up and down Highway 301. After I-95, their income was cut by 50%. Today, Virgil Nail walks among the ruins of her old Rainbow Motel. She never thought it would come to this.
It would have been unpatriotic to protest interstate. And so I guess that we just accepted it as progress.
Motels were hit hardest. The people who serviced automobiles, they lingered on, and finally they went one by one, but it put a lot of people out of business.
Ludowici once had so many gas stations, no one can remember just how many. But after I-95, only one gas station remained.
What supported my business at that time was the local business, the local customers. I was able to survive that impact. However, looking along 301 now and Highway 17, you can see that the impact of 95 really created a lot of problems for business people and families, and probably lost an awful lot.
After I-95, Ludowici slumbered for nearly 20 years. Even today, 70% of the people here have to commute outside of Ludowici or Long County to earn a living. But Claudine Chesser and others decided to change that trend, and their efforts to tear down the derelict buildings and attract new business is slowly starting to pay off.
It went down very, very low, but we are fighting hard to get it back up. We are trying to just encourage the people here to do all they can do to update their businesses and get new stuff in, give it a new look.
Interstate highways have changed America, the way we live, the way we work. I-95, I-85, I-75, I-20 are Georgia's new main streets.
The interstate system is a highway system separate and unique from all other highways in America. 90% of the cost of building the 41,000-mile limited access high-speed roadway is being paid by the federal government, with taxes paid by the highway users. When it is completed in 1972, the network will carry one-fifth of all the country's traffic.
Today, there are nearly 43,000 miles of interstate highways in the United States at a cost of $129 billion. We have more miles than any other nation on Earth. And nearly one quarter of the nation's traffic travels on interstates, even though they represent only 1% of all our roads.
Well, one of the great benefits of the interstate is to drive down the costs of moving goods and material. With the interstate and limited access, you can travel more miles for the same costs than you could in the older systems.
While I-95 hurt Ludowici, interstates have helped the city of Atlanta. Three major interstate highways overlap here, which helped Atlanta become the capital of the South. For example, Peach State Ford Truck Sales is one of the many businesses which wouldn't exist without superhighways. They moved from downtown Atlanta to I-85 because they wanted to be next to the interstate.
We have tractor-trailer operators coming through here 24 hours a day, pulling in for service on their way to New York with a load of flowers, fresh fruit, cabbages, everything, you know.
Peach State sells trucks and repairs them. It's the largest distributor of truck parts in the Southeast. They employ 125 people, and that's the point. Interstates attract business and create jobs.
More than 200,000 people, about one out of every 11 working people in this state work in the trucking industry in some way. The industry pays more than $6.6 billion in payroll, pays more than $400 million a year in taxes just on the vehicles themselves, not including what those folks pay on their income taxes, what everyone pays when they eat, the fuel they buy. In every way, shape, and form, the industry is a vital part of Georgia's economy.
Georgia has more than 1,200 miles of interstate highways. Good roads mean things move.
Anything from a computer games, to starter jackets, inline skates, rollerblades, just about anything you're going to end up using. School books, textbooks, the clothes, the soaps, the hairs, shampoos, anything you're going to use every day got to you on a truck.
This is the road to prosperity. It is already bringing a new kind of life to people like these and to the places where they live. The end of the road lies ahead in the future. The fulfillment of the promises made by these signs of an America designed for the transportation that serves it lies at the end of that road.
The first automobile accident in Georgia occurred in 1901 when a mule ran into a car. Neither man nor beast was injured.